Hey Chris, this is Robert Ian with KunkerChange.com. I was surprised and pleased this week to see a very bullish article on gold written by Ave Gilbert of ElliottWaveTrader.net appear in mainstream media on the homepage of MarketWatch.com. It was titled, "The Next Great Bull Market, Gold, $25,000. There have been a number of articles and discussions appearing lately, each with their own methodology and rationale for calculating the future value of gold. This article began with a simple premise by asking, what if someone approached you in the year 2000, when gold was $250 an ounce, and said it would be trading at 8 times its value a decade later? That's exactly what happened. In September 2011, gold topped at $1,921 an ounce. In fact, the author of the article, Ave Gilbert, called a top of $1,915 in August of 2011, missing the actual top by just $6. He thinks gold could make another similar run over the next decade plus, with the price of gold futures surpassing $25,000. Ave describes himself as the staunchest of gold bears the past 3 years, but indicates he will be switching sides and moving strongly into the bull camp, especially after what he calls the next and final decline, which will likely take place over the next half a year. The next half a year is going to redefine the meaning of conquer change on many fronts. We'll see what China has up their sleeve relative to their currency and physical gold. We'll see what the IMF has up their sleeve relative to special drawing rights and gold. And if we end up getting surprised or shocked on those or other fronts, we may end up seeing what the U.S. has or has had up their sleeve on the gold front. Only time will tell. But when you can't give mining companies away, when you can't give gold and silver away, when the urgency level to finalize anything mining-related is at or near zero, when the staunchest gold bears are about to switch sides in the spotlight of mainstream media, you know that capitulation is near or is already here. Intermission will be concluding shortly, and we will be resuming our feature presentation of the 2008 Economic Collapse and Great Reset, Part 2. Fasten your seatbelt. Chris, I'd like to urge all of our listeners to sign up for my email list at conquerchange.com. And if any of our listeners are ever involved in bringing in keynote speakers for their companies or organizations, please visit my companion website at robertian.com. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with conquerchange.com. Reminding you to follow us on Twitter at Conquer Change. Thanks, Chris.